اشرقت نفسي بنور من فؤادي حينما رددت.
You know who you are, let me give you what your identity is. Your Hawiya, your identity is not that you're British or you're Bengali or you're Pakistani. Your identity that is that you are from the Ummah Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. That's who you are. Remember that. Your father is Ibrahim alaihi salam. Remember that. Your mother is Aisha radhiyallahu anha. Remember that. Your first martyr was Sumayya radhiyallahu anha. Remember that. In your nation, you have people like Hamza. In the nation, you have people like Saad, Musanna, Abu Roha. All of these people you had in your nation. Do not ever forget that. And in this nation, we have people like that again. People who rise and we need to be from them. The Messenger Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam told us in the hadith what we should be doing. Now, dear brothers and sisters, is the time that we should live the life of the Sahaba. Because the Messenger Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, Badal Islam ghariban, wa sayyudu ghariban kama bada, fatuba lil ghuraba. Islam came as something strange, will return as something strange. Tuba for the ghuraba. In this moment of strangeness, where we are people have perverse their ways, have gone against the fitrah, there are people out there. There are people who still want to be Muslims. There are people who still want to submit to Allah. That's how it's supposed to be. Now is the time for us to renew our pledge, like the pledge of the Sahaba. When the Sahaba gave the pledge in the Aqaba, the Thaniya, the second pledge of Aqaba, they made a promise to the Messenger Muhammad. And we too need to make that pledge. They said, Ya Rasulullah, we're going to listen to you and we're going to obey you. That we're going to spend for Islam in the time of plenty and the time of scarcity. That we're going to command good and forbid evil. That we're going to fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala only, no matter what the people say. And we're going to defend you and we're going to defend the deen. Like the way we defend our families. We too need to make that pledge. We need to make the agenda of the Sahaba our agenda. We too need to make the mission of the Sahaba our mission. Because only by doing that, then we can go forward. Because the Messenger Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam recites the most beautiful verse from the many beautiful verses of the Quran. قُلْ إِنَّ الصَّلَاةِ وَنُسُكِي وَمَحْيَايَ وَمَمَاتِ لِلَّهِ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ. Verily, my prayers, my sacrifice, my living, my dying is all for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. La sharika la, I will not associate partners with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in any of this. So dear brothers and sisters, it is a time for us to wake up. Yes, the reality right now we live in is the reality of humiliation for those people who betray the code of Allah. But honor and izzah and karama for those people who return back to the sunnah and work for the establishment of the deen of Allah. Wa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam Muhammad wa alhamdu rabbil alameen.
على